Hey folks, it's Frithgar here, how you doing? Welcome back to Old Times. We've got quite a few things planned for today, and I've got a few surprises as well. I've also got, you know, I said I was going to look for a plough. Apparently, small old-fashioned ploughs are very, very difficult to find decent mods for. I have tried all sorts of mods, and a lot of them are really, really bad mods. Okay, it's unfortunate to have to say it, but there are some awful mods out there. There are some absolutely fantastic ones, but there are some really, really bad ones as well. And I've gone through a lot of bad ploughs. The bigger ones, they're fine. So in the end, what I've had to do is I have gone for this one. Now there were reversible ploughs. Before 1980, in the 60s and 70s in particular, there were several reversible ploughs available. I've got this one. I could get a four-furrow one as well. I've got a Lemkin pack, and there will be a link for it in the description down below. But before I get to any more of that, we need to go to today's question. This picture here, this is a Pika Model 75. This was the first automated tree cutter, and it would delim and cut logs to set lengths. This was made in 1975. This here is the closest mod that I can find that represents the Pika 75. Okay, I know it's not exact, but what I'm asking you is, do you think that I should use it? Do you think I can use that and we'll call it the Pika 75? So let me know, yes or no, in the comment section down below. It's your vote, it's your game. Now, I have got that plough. I'll just quickly show you. This one doesn't actually have a picture. That is a huge 10-meter plough, which actually has cultivators attached to it. So it does ploughing and cultivating in one pass. That's not something we'll be using now. It's a much more modern plough. This one could get away with being classed as a 70s plough. We're using this one here. I did look at this one. There are no mold boards on it at all. That is just literally just flat. I will not be using that lizard. It is awful. I don't like it. And I also have, let me just show you the tractor. I was torn, because I need a 100 horsepower tractor, so I've hired the plough, I've hired a tractor. I was torn between getting that one and this ancient old Russian import here. This one's 220 horsepower. It's a cheap machine, but it's very powerful. It's what there is, an old Russian one. So I've actually gone with that one. Let me show you now. Oop, here we go. Right, the grand reveal. Oh, and we got that one. We get to that. So this is the machine that I have hired. We've got this sort of on a test, really, hire, for pulling our plough. Now, this would pull the four-furrow plough quite easily as well, but I thought I'd go for the slightly smaller plough this time. I've also got this one to gather up the straw. It's a older forage wagon, one of the earlier ones. It probably doesn't chop very well, but all told, it is quite a tidy little machine. So let's get going with this one. This thing is a beast. Start him up. He's kind of quiet, actually, until he gets going. That roar is, I quite like. Yeah, I don't know how well you can hear it. I do tend to find that it's most of the machines are actually a bit quieter on this map. I try to adjust my sound levels when I edit to make it so that you can hear the machines, but you can also hear me quite clearly. So just got to pick this one up. Now, obviously, this is much bigger than anything we've used yet, but don't forget that I will be using anything up to the 1980s. Up to 1980. So it is still within in keeping for the map. Oh, this is awful. I feel really sorry for the poor Russian farmers that had to drive this thing. There is no visibility out of this thing at all. It's terrible. Right, this is a fantastic, fantastic mod. I remember this one, actually. I used this in 2013, and I really liked it then. It's cheap, and it's kind of cheap and cheerful, but it's really, really powerful and robust as well. This thing could take a lot of damage, take a lot of abuse. And we have a reversible plough. The one thing I don't like about this particular plough is it is a little bit wider than sort of the furrows show up wider than what the actual plough is doing. But it needs to be said, compared to some of the other mods, this thing is fantastic, right? I have seen some absolutely awful mods. And for some reason, the game, the hired help doesn't really like non-reversible ploughs, which is why I've gone for this. Because I did have a four-furrow plough, which is non-reversible, but the hired help really struggles to use it. It doesn't like non-reversible plough. It will go one way, and then when it tries to go the other way, it says that, oh, actually, we're finished, and just stops. So I wasn't able to really use it all that well. Let's get a... oh, hang on. My plough needs to be reversed. Let's just turn it over. There we go. Just need to call it there. There we go. Right, it does have a nice action on it, and it might sort of seem a little bit modern, and I would agree with you there. It does seem a little bit modern, but... We're sort of making do with what we've got here. The one thing I don't like about using a articulated machine on a plough is its tendency to wiggle the plough around. So I'm going to have to apologise for that. This one needs quite a bit more to more space for turning on headlands, which is one thing I'm trying to accommodate for now. So I'm going to go on and do this now, and then we can just leave him to get on with the job, and then we can go and take a look at that new forage wagon. Well, not new, it's we've hired it for the day, so we got that one to use as well. All the straw is rode up and ready to go, so I'm just going to make this headland a little bit bigger, and then I'll set him going on this field, and then we'll get back to you. Now he's away doing that field there, doing a grand job, and he does need a lot of space to turn on the headland because it's the articulated machine. He doesn't actually have that good a turning circle, but never mind, we won't worry about that. While I remember, the bale trailer that I've got is still around. I've just taken it up to the farm up the top, the cattle farm, and I've put it up there for now. And let's start this one up. I'm thinking, I forgot to check. We've slept the night since then. We have ready to harvest and ready to harvest. So we've got corn ready to harvest and we've got sugar beet ready to harvest. The potatoes aren't ready yet, but they will be soon. So that is going to be something that we're going to do very, very soon. But first, I'm going to gather the straw with this one. And after I've gathered the straw with this one, we might actually... that will probably be it for... this episode, because we'll test this one out and we'll go back and make sure that the plough is all working fine. That was a nice little touch, actually, that wheel winding up. But yeah, so we just see if there's any new options that we got on this. Nope, it's just fairly standard. Right, I'm going to take this one out to the field out here and we can get started on this. Okay, I think I will come out of cab to start this one off. So let's lower that down. Start her up. I don't actually know what horsepower this one requires. I've got to check. Let's just take a quick look at that a minute. Go into here. There'll be a link for this one in the description down below as well. It is this one, the Krone 2500. It's actually nearly 12,000 euros to buy. We can also get that one. That's even more expensive. But this one actually holds more than the... Is it Bucher? Bucher? I'm not quite sure how to pronounce that. But this one does actually hold more than that one. It's not a huge machine, but it does hold a fair slice. So we'll see how this compares to bales, because one load of bales gets us about 800 euros. I'm not quite sure what this one's going to get. Sort of ignore the outside round, because I go around a few times to make sure that I've gathered everything up. You do tend to get more crop out of the outside round than you do out of the rest of it. It's 12.5 tons, actually. 12,500 litres. There we go. Right. That one's full. Take this one straight back to the yard. And because we're going to be able to do the sugar beet soon, I've got this harvester, and I think you guys are going to like this harvester. This harvester is a fantastic mod. I have tested it. I've tested it thoroughly. We will be selling direct, so I'll have to find out where's the best place to go and sell the sugar beet. And then that should, I'm hoping, give us enough money that we can hire a different combine with a corn header so that we can harvest the maize. Now, let's back this one in here. We're not getting any cows, so we don't need to worry about other straw. I'll put that one right in there and unload. No, which is unload. Oh, I need to come forward a bit. There. Right. Oh, no, it's just regular unload for this. Back lifts up. Right, how much are we going to get for one load? It's a job to compare, really. I mean, you get... Is it 300 litres per bale? That would make... Right, we got 500 euros exactly for one load of loose straw. So... Is it... I think it's 300 litres in a bale. In those small bales. So if it's 300 litres in a small bale... Then that would make... 3,000 litres for 10 bales. That doesn't seem right. I think it's 250. 2,500. And then... You know, I really don't know. I was trying to figure out... See if I could cleverly figure out how much... Yeah, let's gather that up. I'll gather up some of these extra loose bits. Yeah, how many litres of straw are in one load of bales so that we can sort of run a more accurate comparison? I don't think we're going to be able to do that. At least I'm not. I'm just not bright enough. So if someone can remember how many litres was in a bale, then we might be able to run a comparison and see how many bales, how many litres of straw goes in one trailer. Because I also would like to know, do the... bales sell, or does the straw in the bales sell for the same amount that the straw loose sells for? That would be quite an interesting comparison to run. So I would really like to know about that one. Now, if I just gather up this, I'm conscious of the fact that I've had to hire a load of machinery today, so I've used up a lot of my money. I have sold that small plough, which is how I was able to afford to do it, because otherwise I just would not have had enough money. But... This means I'm also going to need quite a bit of money to hire the machine that I've got planned for doing the sugar beet harvest. I might be able to borrow a little bit more, but the problem is we're already paying over 800 euros at midnight each night for our loan. We've got crops in, so it might be that we have to just sort of bite the bullet and sell some of our crops without waiting for a great demand. This is going to be a tough one. This really is going to be a tough one. I think maybe we're going to need to do a bit of logging soon. So whatever the results of the question over this week, we might just need to go and do some logging, regardless of, you know, whether we're going to be using a chainsaw or try and use that, or sort of our version of the Pika. So we can make a little bit of money, because we will get a decent bit of money, I think, for logging, and we can also get money for wood chips. And I got a bit of a surprise for you for the wood chips. Some of you may decide that you don't really like what I'm going to be doing with it, but the machine, you know, it's the Jens wood chipper. That thing is too modern, okay? That's not going to fit in. And obviously I said the Brooks chipper, the one that mounts on the front of the tractor that I've used in the time lapse, I won't be using that in any Let's Play because that is simply too unrealistic. So the one that I've got lined up is kind of a big thing. It is a very, very big thing, I should say. But I think it also fits. I think it would fit. But anyway, I'm going to do another couple loads of straw now and at least finish this field, and we get started on next field. And we can go and check on our plough as well, because it looks like he's stopped. Yeah, here's our plough. All he's done is he's just come up there and went a little bit far on this end piece. That's alright. They do that sometimes, the hired helps. So let's turn him round. I do like this tractor. I don't want to use it all the time. I certainly don't like using it too much for anything that is rigid on the back, like the ploughing and that, because if you're doing it yourself, every time you turn the corner, you sort of swing the plough sideways, and I don't like the way it does that. Right, that should be lined up. Oop, no, wait. I need to turn the plough over. Turn that one over. There we go. Come back in, and there, now, right. Oops. Right, you carry on. Oh, that's fantastic. Look at the thing chugging away. Smoke bellowing out. That's awesome. Right, now I'm going to go and gather up a load more straw. I've about had enough of harvesting, to be honest, or at least the corn harvests. It's going to be time for something significantly different soon. We need to get some money first. The animation on this is actually pretty cool when it comes to tipping out. I mean, I say pretty cool. It is good. Okay, I do tend to get a little bit overexcited about some things. But yeah, it just suddenly struck me. I was looking at it. I thought I'd pull out a little bit further and just watch the animation as it tips and everything. It does work fairly well. I quite like it. One thing I would like to see, because a lot of these things have got bed chains. You can see the bed chains on that one there. It's just the slats with two chains on each side, with a chain on each side. And they basically just push everything out the back. And I would like to see, rather than just the level lowering down, I am hoping that 2017 has a more realistic kind of emptying mode, where instead of just kind of a level lowering down, you actually see it sort of moving out the back. I think that would be absolutely awesome. But I'm not going to hold my breath on that, because I think that would take quite a significant amount of processing power to sort of implement. So, yeah, maybe in another couple of versions' time. Give it another 5 to 10 years, and maybe we'll be able to see that as well. I do have to, while I remember, collect up the agromet that I've parked by the side of the field over there. That one has got to be collected up and put away. So we will have to do that soon. But probably not today. We're going to run out of time soon. Actually, I'm going to come out of cab again, and we're going to just admire this one working. It does look really cool. I do like this. And that... There isn't very much... Yeah, you've probably noticed I keep saying that everything looks really cool and everything looks really awesome and I really like it. I do quite like looking at all the different machines. I like seeing machinery working, and these mods are really well made. The Classics mod, obviously, is the Giant's own one. But this trailer, I'm not sure who did it, actually. There is a link. I always try to get the original link rather than what someone has stolen and re-uploaded to some of the smaller upload sites, which is something I absolutely despise. You should not steal other people's work and then try to profit on it from yourself. Try to profit off of it. But that aside, this mod is really well made. It's the whole thing is constructed well. It's got a lot of nice little details, like the fabric pieces across the top there, and the wires along the top. Now, when I was younger, we actually had a forage wagon. I can't remember the make of them. We had one was green and green and white, and one was red and white. And they didn't look that dissimilar to the one that we're towing now. It had the wires along the top, and just slats down the sides. The modern ones that you see now, they're completely different. It's a whole different ball game, that is. And really, the older ones, all they would do is pick the stuff up. You might... the knives would cut it a little bit, but yes, it wasn't like the precision chop type ones that you get now. The ones that you get now chop it up nearly as well as an actual forager does. So it's completely different, the much more modern ones. I don't know why I keep backing into there. I need to do it out here so it'll actually activate the tip trigger. Right, let's tip that. And if I come forward a bit, we can just watch that tipping. I can't see it very well. But yeah, if it was to like move the whole block backwards and then fall off the back, I think that would be very, very cool. It's not going to do that, so we won't worry about that this time. Has the plough finished? Let's go and check him. It is just about time to go. So the question for this week is the Pika Model 75. This picture right here. Do you want me to use this mod? And let me go to it. It's from a forestry pack that I have got. This mod here Would you be happy for this one to pass off as a Pika Model 75, which was manufactured in 1975, so it is eligible for the map? It's just whether or not you are happy for me to pass this one off as the Pika 75. And this one has come up across the field and stopped again. There was a little patch just here somewhere that didn't plough properly, which is why it's done it, I think. So I'm going to get this one going again. Before the next episode, I will finish this field. I won't worry about finishing another field. I might actually just cut the headland out on the next field so that that's ready to go as well. But, yeah, I'll at least finish this field so that we've done something. And then if we decide that we're not going to start the sugar beet next week, we'll... maybe we will do some forestry or something like that, and we can do a bit more ploughing. And then we've also got to cultivate this field, because obviously now that it's ploughed, we've got to cultivate it before we can do any drilling. So I'll leave that one to go down there. So if you've enjoyed this episode, then please head down below and give us a like. And if you really enjoyed it, please tell your friends all about me. Get them to come along and watch as well. That would be awesome. So until next time, thank you very much for watching. This is Frithgar. Goodbye, and see you later.